Got some decimal addition here for you.
Yeah, I know, I know. You know how to do this. You line up the decimal points, you add the corresponding digits. I want to focus on why that works, because in math, the whys are way more important than the whats. Once you have the whys down, you can make your own whats. Here, we're going to focus on how decimal addition works by looking at the place values of each of these digits. So 3.75, 3.75, the 3 is in the units place, that's 3 times 10 to the 0. The 7 is in the tenths place, that's 10 to the minus 1, so that's 7 times 10 to the minus 1. And the 5 is out there in the hundredths place, that's 5 times 10 to the minus 2. And we're going to do the same thing with 12.8. The 1 is in the tens place, tens, that's just 10 to the first. The 2 is in the units place. And the 8 is in the tenths place. And we don't have any hundredths. Now we're going to add these up. All we've done here is broken out each of these decimals in terms of each of their places, each of the place values and powers of 10. Now we're going to add them up. We have the 1 times 10 to the first. There's no 10 to the first up here to combine it with. Here we have 3 times 10 to the 0 plus 2 times 10 to the 0. That's just 5 times 10 to the 0. It's kind of like adding 3x and 2x. And over here we have 7 tenths and 8 tenths. That gives us 15 tenths. And then over here we still have the 5 hundredths all by itself. And now if we wanted to sit down and just write this out as a decimal number, we got a 1 in tens place, 5 in the units place, and a 15 in the tenths place. What's that all about? Well, I can take my 15 and I can break that up into 10 plus 5. 10 tenths and 5 tenths. I'm going to split that up into 10 tenths and 5 tenths. And all I'm doing here is just breaking this up into two pieces here. Now 10 tenths, 10 to the first, times 10 to the minus 1 is 10 to the 0. 10 to the 0, that gives me another one in the units place. So I have 5 times 10 to the 0 plus another 10 to the 0. That's going to give me 6 times 10 to the 0. Of course, I still have my 1 times 10 to the first out here, and I have the 5 tenths left over back here, and the 5 hundredths. And now I can just pound out the answer here. I can write down each decimal place. We've got the 1 in the tens place, the 6 in the units place, the 5 in the tenths place, and the 5 in the hundredths place. This is why decimal addition works the way you're used to. And let's take a quick look at that. The way you're used to doing this is you just line up the decimals and then you add. The 5 in the hundredths place, there's no hundredths here, so put in that, there's an imaginary 0 out there. It's not so imaginary now. We add the 5 and the 0. We get 5. 7 tenths and 8 tenths is 15 tenths. We bring the 5 down and regroup the other 10. The other 10 tenths makes a 1. And then we add 1, 3, and 2 gives us 6. And then the tens, well, that's just 10. And then we bring the decimal point down, keep it in place. This is just a shorthand way of doing this. All we did here was bring down the hundredths, combine the tenths, 7 tenths, 8 tenths is 15 tenths, which we broke up into another 1 and 5 tenths. We took this extra 1 here, combined it with the 3 ones and the 2 ones, that gave us 5. 5 plus the extra 1 gives us 6, and then we brought down our tens. All we're doing here is this. And now you know why this works, so you have another tool to go make some whats.